Hi, good afternoon, everyone. I know it's close to lunch, so I will be quick. Any case, I speak fast, so it'll be quick. Don't worry too much. And firstly, I don't know how competent I'm to talk about this. The guy who's actually competent walked in with me, the ex-CEO of Bagh, Parthodas Gupta. Probably you best understanding of technology and measurement in this country, having set up a world-class measurement body from start. So I think, so probably in a manner of speaking, I'm stepping in for him. But to quickly get going on TV measurement metrics, I'll close with two thoughts, which I those who attended earlier sessions or those who know me are, I'm a one-trick pony, so I do exactly consistently. So I'll say that in the end, but in advance, finally, what beyond TV measurement? But before that, a bit of a backdrop. So, you know, rightly so, because of the way the economy has been the last 6-7 months, and we are victims of what we call chronological time versus subjective time. So, if I get the chronology, we look at what's happened in the last 6 months, and that becomes the, as they say in Hindi, high toba. So, everyone's saying, why is television growing? What's happening? You know, and is digital killing us? Digital taking over? And that's life, which digital may be growing dramatically, no doubt. But is it the end of the world as far as television is concerned? So, I'll put up one slide, which is, if you look, this is a PwC report, very, very busy slide, got a lot on it. But if you see from a global standpoint, everything in the entertainment and media industry in the country is, is perhaps the highest in the world. So everything which is related to TAT. So if you see the last 5 years, because finally the economies are measured over a 10-year period or a 5-year period, not what's happened in the last 6 months. Yes, the last 6 months may be hurting us, but that is something which we will tide over. The point is that, you know, this is the highest rate of growth across media, not only just television. And so too television. Television also is growing across the board. So the reason I put up this slide, nothing to do with measurement at this point in time, but we rest assured that this is a passing phase. You know, it's going to be dramatic. It's going to grow. And compared to what's happening in the world, finally, media entertainment is a reflection of the GDP growth. India will be one of the fastest growing GDP markets. Normally the indication is double that size. So TV media entertainment should be double the size. So I think I want to show everyone not to get worried by what's happening currently, but it is a long-term future for the country. If you look at this whole story which I spoke about being digital, yes, digital is growing. Digital is taking over our lives, undoubtedly. But if you see what's the situation of advertising spends all over the world, I picked up some key markets. And if you see, other than China, most of the other markets, TV is still sizable. So including United States, which is 42% digital, if you see the second column, but TV is still there, you know, TV is still 41% or so. So it's still sizable as far as I'm concerned, you know. India, of course, television is the mainstay. So the point is that except China, television still is the largest medium and is, in a manner of speaking, holding its own. While there is a move towards content rather than the platform between TV, OTT and digital or whatever. But the fact is, the way it's measured and the way it's captured today, television still is a strong medium across the world. Some of the other mediums are taking a hit, but television remains. And coming to the point of measurement which was made, you know, and this is a story which some people sitting in the room, like Parthu and the others and the Bagh team, started and embarked upon 6 years back. Happy to report, it is perhaps the most advanced in the world. It's the largest panel in the world. So we measure, Bagh measures 170,000 individuals. If you see, compared to any other, anything, I mean, people complain that measurement in this country is not accurate and not, I'll talk about it slightly later, but measurement is not representative, is not big enough. Look at markets like China, which is far bigger population than India and probably as heterogeneous than as us, you know. So even the structure of homogeneity is not there. It's 30,000 individuals. So if you look at an average home of 4 or 5, the sample is 5,000 homes. So look at China, look at Japan, 5,000 individuals. Germany, 10,000. UK, 11,000. The only one which is sizable is US, which is 1 lakh plus individuals. So if you see for this, you know, obviously the story is that India is very, very large. And the other thing is, if you see the other figures which are there, which is the point which I want to make along with this, look at television penetration. So you'll find on the right, black numbers are the numbers which are you know, absolute number of individuals left his homes. So India has 83.6 crore individuals. The only market which is bigger than this is China, which is 29 billion individuals. So the point is, which I'll show you in a later slide, that television penetration all over the world is very high. If you see here, 96%, 95% across. India is only 66%. So obviously there's huge headroom. So while we have a strong, robust mechanism in place, perhaps the largest, and if I may say so, with unbiased, best in the world. But having said that, is also the fact that there's headroom for growth. So India is still at 70% or 66% penetration. There's a long way to go in terms of television. Imagine what will happen, and I'll show you some indicators later. When you're saying that two-third penetration becomes 95% penetration, like some of the leading markets, and it will be good there. 95% penetration will happen in India. So this is the point. So this is a bit misleading because the base is total homes or total individuals in the country. So this also captures the 33% which you don't have television just now, and therefore may watch television, may not watch television. But if you see the data across other markets, because you see that South America and North America, 3.5 hours of viewing, which is viewing time. If you look at Europe, if you see Africa, everywhere is 3.5 hours. Of course, Asia is a bit less. India is 2.4 hours. Now, this is, so therefore, the point I'm making is there's headroom to growth. And this headroom is primarily because of number of homes, which are not, we don't have the opportunity of television at this point in time, which will change. Also, in terms of viewing habit, it's not that, you know, viewing is coming down. And which is the point I'll make later, that when you come to viewing, even that you will see going up. The, one of the other points which always makes, how can a panel of 40,000 homes or 1,70,000 individuals, is it representative of the country? You know, how can you measure? So the one point we made earlier, that even the large markets like China and Japan are far, far lower in terms of what we do. Now, this is again is an extremely busy slide, provided to me by my friends who are statisticians. But the point is that at 95% confidence, if you see the error level, if you look at 0.1% reach, you know, the error level, if you increase the sample to say from 1,70,000 individuals to 4 lakh or 5 lakh, the error level just marginally decreases. So the utility of increasing the sample dramatically doesn't help the cost. So unless you have some other measurement mechanism which comes into place where all homes are measured, which is possible through return path data in the long run. But at this point in time, that facility is not there for a variety of reasons. So the limited point is that, you know, repeatedly you hear, and you hear from very senior people within the industry, within the government and various other stakeholders saying, if you were to increase the sample, in fact, if I'm not mistaken, the TRI guideline talks about taking the sample up every year. So if you're talking of a sample of 45,000 homes or 1,70,000 individuals, going up to 2 lakh homes and say maybe 8 lakh individuals is meaningless, because the level of error is not going to come down, and the utility of that with the huge cost you're going to incur is not there. So this is a bit misleading. So the point I'm making is that, you know, at 40,000, 50,000 meters, our homes, which is 2 lakh plus individuals or 2 lakh 50,000 individuals, is good enough sample to pick up even a heterogeneous country like India. It is strong enough. So bear this point in mind. Now coming back to the headroom and growth point I made earlier, if you see on the left, you know, it is just two-third penetration so far. And if you see on the right, now this base is different, so don't go by the 2 hours there. That 2 hours was in the entire population. But if you see here, on the people who have TV homes or people who have access to TV or watch television, the average time is already 3 hours today. And it's not that, you know, because of perception is OTT and digital and all this coming together, the consumption of television is coming down. That's not true. So consumption of television is actually, in a manner of speaking, going up. Think about it. This is a big point. I mean, you know, when you see the macro numbers. So a lot of myths I'm trying to bust. While my topic is measurement, but I'm going beyond measurement. So if you look at, and I don't know how many people, this is all bulk data. So I don't know how many of you access it. The fact is that television measurement in the last 5 years or 4 years, television time has gone up. And I dare say this will go up even further. It may not go up dramatically, but it will go up further for a variety of reasons. Look at India as a whole. Don't look at India as a prism of the small audience which watches Netflix and Amazon Prime. Other point, you know, people say we don't watch advertising. Advertising is not seen. You know, are losing people. Not only are they not watching television, whatever they watch, they switch off when advertising comes on. Look at this. This is another interesting slide. So again, looking at the thing, look at the bottom first. So look at, audience sampled in a week, and almost 95% or 98% of them have watched ads on TV. So if you look at that, you know, it's a very high number. It's not that, and if you look at the total SET on advertising, if you see seconds, from 2016 to 2019, there's growth in things. So the absolute volumes are going up. If you look at the share of top 10 advertisers, that's somewhat static. It's growing. So there are other categories coming in. So the fact is, the business we are in, Mr. Balsara and me, and many of you in the room, don't lose heart. There is momentum, you know. So the 2 points I want to leave behind that, you know, is TV dying? Is TV going out of fashion? That's not true. There's room for penetration. Penetration will go up. There's more time being spent on television, as the data proves. It may not go substantially, but still 3.5 hours is a lot of time. And advertising is being watched. These are very macro figures. Obviously, when you start bringing them into your sport and your run, that's a different factor. But these are three broad things we'll talk about. And the original thought that it is today one of the most robust measurement systems in the world. I showed it to you all over the world that how probably in my mind, after US, India, qualitative, of course, scale-wise, India is bigger than US, but that's because the population is so much more. But compared to other markets, I mean, billions of dollars of advertising is traded in Japan and China and other markets in the world, in Europe. Ours is a far more robust and a far bigger and a better mechanism. With the technology we have in place, I'm not speaking about technology today, but with the, our watermarking technology is far, far superior and far more reliable. And compare this with other medium. And I purposely picked out digital. You see, there's no third-party measurement. Supposed to be a highly evolved medium. Technology, publishers put out their own numbers. Nothing wrong in that. But finally, clients and agencies will always buy third-party data. There is no measurement in place there. So I think that's the challenge, because if you're going to move in that direction, there will be need to fix this. And I'll close with this 2 points I'm going to make. So the two thoughts. You know, with so much headroom for growth in India, and I've been saying this from different forums, so why not one more time? You know, so there's so much headroom for growth. It's not fair on the ecosystem. So while from a negotiating tactic, it may make a lot of sense to say we're going with CPRP, you're not giving the benefit of the headroom which is there. But in real terms, if you're a good planner or if you're a good marketeer, you'll always look at audiences which you've covered. We finally go by audiences. We are planning for audiences. We are buying for audiences. And if you're buying and planning for audiences, I genuinely believe the truth lies, you know. So in my mind, and I say this, I've said it consistently, and I keep saying it till the time I'm in this business. Trading and measurement are two different things. So trading is between a buyer and a seller, whatever the price they're willing at. There's no such thing as. So people, you know, a lot of people I speak to, very, very senior people, say, listen, if we go the CPT route, our rates will go up. Why will they go up? I mean, I'm not going to answer this question that why will, if you move from CPRP to CPT. Finally, when marketeers are looking at their audiences, it's all on audience numbers. It's nothing on, you know, that per rating point. There's no such thing as a rating point there. So I don't know why we are hung up as a metric in this country. On most countries in the world operate on CPDs, you know, cost per thousands or whatever. So this is something which has foxed me. I think it's a mindset and a psychology issue in this country. The truth is that finally that is where truly reflect everything which I spoke about earlier, be it headroom, be it time spent, be it the increased penetration of television, all that will be captured realistically there. And like I said, the trading, the financial part of it is supply and demand. It's got nothing to do with whether you do a CPRP or CPT. You can reset. In fact, I'm not very good at these numbers. My dear friend Vikram Suja always explains that how, because if you move to CPT, some numbers, some prices have to come down. Some of the channels. So I think that's one more attempt I'll make to say that we must, keep these two separate. And my final point, as I run out of time, is again a point which is spoken about. Again, it's a mindset issue. It's not a issue of reality. Yes, there is a tremendous need for a unified measurement of TV plus digital. You know, and this is where I'll request the marketers in the room to put pressure. Because today, it's again a psychology issue. Like I spoke about CPD and CPRP being all a mindset issue, not doing anything with reality. Same thing here. So, you know, digital companies, some of them feel that with transparency in media, digital villa numbers get found out. Why will they get found out if you're confident of your medium? If you think the medium is growing and if you think the medium is delivering in terms of whatever platform you are on, so then you need to ensure that there is transparency in third-party data, because at some point in time, advertisers will start asking questions. With advertisers have some ways, indirect ways of looking at measurement. So why should we be one shy away from measurement? There are enough stakeholders. The digital guys feel that the OTT guys will gain because they're getting more targeted and more personalized. The OTT guys feel the big boys in the publishing world like Google and Facebook will gain. Nevertheless, it is finally the advertisers who will gain when there's transparency in measurement. So my plea to, I think what I'm saying, all of you agree, that measurement on video, which is digital, is very important, which will lead to an integration of one view of video, which is what Bach is capable of. By the way, Bach is empowered and capable, and they know how to do it. They have run pilots, they have put up digital panels, all that is in place. So it's not about capability and technology like we have done in television. The same capability and technology exists in digital. They are ready with it. It's a mindset. So my appeal to all the advertisers in the room, and I see quite a few of them, is to put pressure on the ecosystem to say, listen, this has to be done. You know, if you want business from us, must ensure that there is one measurement. So closing, nothing new from me. I'll just close by saying two points. One, have faith in television. There's enough headroom. People are still watching television. They're going to keep continue watching your ads. They're not going away. And there's two other points is that finally, look at CPT. CPT is a great way to compare data, to do audience planning, to understand how audiences are behaving. It has nothing to do with pricing. It will not affect pricing in any way. And the second point is we need to get advertisers to push and move towards our digital friends, OTT friends, big broadcasters, everyone to say, guys, we have the capability in India. We have a great rating mechanism, which is Bach. Why can't you start moving towards digital measurement and one view? And then after that, one view will happen. By the way, Bach is geared for that also. So TV plus digital can easily be put out once you have that. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.